We want to turn now to an important story that broke late Friday. A federal judge is ruling that the government's collection of phone records is constitutional. This in contrast to another federal judge's ruling just 11 days earlier that said it likely wasn't. The case ultimately might be headed to the Supreme Court. For more about the timing of all this and about what constitutional issues might determine the outcome of the case, we're joined now from Washington by Adam Liptak. He's a Supreme Court reporter for the New York Times. So the judges couldn't have disagreed more on more things in these rulings. So let's first start about their disagreement on the whether or not this this government program to capture data from our cell phone records even worked.
They were far apart on every part of this case. On the facts, the most recent judge, the one in New York on Friday, said that this program, this NSA program that collects records, could have prevented 9/11. And he seemed persuaded by several other instances in which the government asserts the program made a difference in preventing terrorist attacks.
And let's talk a little bit about the constitutionality question underneath. You know, what's interesting is the most recent judge said that we have a fundamental right but are not an absolute right to privacy, and that starts to look at the unreasonable search and seizures in the Fourth Amendment.
Right. The constitutional question starts with, do we have a reasonable expectation of privacy in information we turn over to third parties like phone companies? The Supreme Court back in 1979, in a very different era, said we do not, and therefore the Fourth Amendment doesn't even get implicated. The judge 2 weeks ago in Washington said that 1979 decision doesn't make any sense in the modern age of smartphones and big data and the ability to put together a whole mosaic of information about our private lives. The new judge said, listen, the Supreme Court said third-party data is not protected, and I'm not going to go beyond what the Supreme Court says.
And so what happens next? I mean, is this likely where two judges of this sort disagree? Are there other cases pending? Eventually, does the Supreme Court decide to hear it?
So there are several other cases pending. These two will take the lead. They'll go up to federal appeals courts in New York and Washington. If they disagree, it almost surely goes to the Supreme Court. And if any appeals court strikes down a major national security agency program, the Supreme Court's very likely to take it. But there's another scenario, too, which is that the Washington decision striking down the program starts to look like an outlier. And if all the appeals courts say, no, it's okay, then maybe the Supreme Court stays out of it.
And the Supreme Court is likely to do what? In the terms of they're very, very cautious about challenging previous decisions that they've made.
That's true, although just in 2012, in a case involving GPS devices, five different justices, albeit in concurring opinions, expressed hesitation about this old rule, saying that new technology might require re-examination of the idea that merely because third parties know our data, we lose an expectation of privacy in it.
So if this issue does make it to the Supreme Court, is there any indication on how the justices would break? Is this a liberal versus conservative issue?
If you look at it through the lens of national security, the answer would be yes. If you look at it through the lens of the Fourth Amendment more generally, the court has been scrambled, and a conservative like Justice Scalia has occasionally taken a more protective attitude toward privacy rights than some of his conservative brethren. So it depends which lens you look at it through.
All right, Adam Liptak from the New York Times, thanks so much.
Good to be here.